Good morning, children. In the last video, you come to know about laws of reflection of light and also the types of reflection. When the light falls on the different nature of surface, how does the reflection takes place? Children, two basic things are really very important when we are talking about reflection. One is an object. As I spoke about an object already, it may be a luminous which emits own light, or it may be a non-luminous, just reflecting in light. Okay. So when the light falls on when the object from the light falls on the mirror, immediately it reflects and it produces an image. It produces an image. So what is an image? It is a virtual representation of an object. The best example is when you go and stand in front of the mirror at your home, you may able to see a virtual representation of yourself. So that is called as an image. There are two types of an image. One is called as a real image. Another one is a virtual image. So the real image is always inverted, whereas the virtual image is erect, or we can call it as an upright. So when you stand in front of the mirror, are you getting a real image or a virtual image? Please think. In the above video, if you observe the experiment, you will come to know the person is focusing the candle light through the lens. So he is observing an image on the screen. So you will be able to see the image formed on the screen are inverted. So any image that is inverted, we call it as a real image. If it is not formed on the screen, other than that it forms on the mirror or lens. So we call that one as a virtual image. So the image, if it is inverted, it is a real. If it is not inverted, if it is upright, we call it as a virtual. So these are the differences between real and in virtual. So the real image is formed when the light rays start from the object. Meet after reflection, we call it as a real image. Whereas in virtual, it appeared to meet. So when we draw ray diagram, you will understand it better. So for your understanding, let me tell you, if the image is formed on the screen, it is a real image. If it is cannot be formed on the screen, we call it as a virtual image. So the real image is always inverted, whereas the virtual image is always erect, or you can say upright. So now you would have observed that the image formed in the mirror, when you stand in front of it, it is a virtual image because you are getting an erect image of yourself. Now let us discuss the characteristics of the image formed by the plane mirror. As I told you, just stand in front of the mirror. Okay, you will observe an image, we call it as a virtual image. This is the first point. Second point, it is erect or an upright, it is erect in nature. And third one, the height of the object is same as an height of the image. So if the small girl come and stand in front of the mirror, the image is also small. If the person was really taller than that girl, if they stand in front of the mirror, it appears to be tall. So the height of the image is always equal to the height of the object. Fourth point, the distance between the mirror and an object is equal to the distance between the mirror and an image. For example, if you are standing 50 centimeter away from the mirror, the image produced in the mirror will also be 50 centimeter away from the mirror. The fifth point, the image is laterally inverted. What do you mean by lateral inversion? So it is like when the object raises the right hand in front of the mirror, the image raises the left hand. It appears to rise as the left hand. So this one we call it as an lateral inversion. I hope you understood all the 5 points of a characteristic of image formed by the plane mirror. First one is a virtual image. and it is erect, then same height with the object as well as an image, and the distance between the object and the mirror and the image and the mirror are same. And then the fifth one is a lateral inversion. I hope you understood the concept of characteristics of the image formed by a plane mirror. Thank you.